In this video, I'm going to be finishing the Complete the Square worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. There will be a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, remembering the formula for completing the square, when we're in the form of x squared plus bx plus c, is that c, the value we're looking for, is equal to b over 2 squared. So regardless of whether this b is positive or negative, when we square it, c will always be positive. So in number 5, b is a fraction, 5/19. So dividing by 2 is the same as multiplying by 1/2. So I'm going to take the fraction 5/19 and multiply by 1/2, and then we're squaring that quantity to find the value c. 5 times 1 is 5, all over 19 times 2, which is 38. And that is squared. Now I'm going to distribute that exponent of 2 to the 5 and to the 38. So I will have 5 squared over 38 squared, which 5 squared is 25, and 38 squared is 1,444. So 25 over 1,444 is my solution in number 15. Moving on to number 16, my b value is 2/5. So I'll have 2/5, and I'll multiply that by 1/2, and then square that quantity. So that will be 2 over 10 squared. However, I'll simplify 2 over 10 since both are divisible by 2. So 2 divided by 2 is 1, and 10 divided by 2 is 5. So not changing the value of 2/10, I just simplified the fraction to 1/5, but I'm still squaring that quantity. So I'll have 1 squared over 5 squared when I distribute that exponent of 2, which will be 1 over 25, or 1/25, as my solution in number 16. In number 17, my b value is a whole number 11. So I'll divide that by 2. And then once I divide it by 2, I'll square it to get my value of c. So 11 over 2 squared is 11 squared over 2 squared once I distribute that exponent. 11 squared is 121, and 2 squared is 4. 121 over 4 is my solution in number 17. In number 18, my b value is a whole number 6. So 6 divided by 2 squared will equal c. 6 over 2 is 3, so 3 squared is equivalent to c, which is 9. So 9 is my value for completing the square in number 18. In number 19, my b value is 19. So 19 over 2, and I'll be squaring that. That's 19 squared over 2 squared. 19 squared is equal to 361, and 2 squared is equal to 4. So 361 divided by 4 is my solution in number 19. In number 20, my b is 10. So 10 divided by 2 squared will equal c. 10 divided by 2 can be simplified to 5, since 2 goes into 10 evenly, and then I'm still squaring that value to get to c. 5 squared is equal to 25. For number 21, I'll have 17 over 2 squared. That's 17 squared divided by 2 squared, which is 289 divided by 4. 17 times 17 is 289, and 2 times 2 is 4. For number 22, I'll have 34. I'll be dividing that by 2 and then squaring that quantity. 34 divided by 2 is equal to 17, and 17 squared is equal to 289. That is my c value for number 22. And number 23, my b is 8, so 8 divided by 2 squared is 4 squared, and 4 squared is 16. So 16 is my answer. In number 24, my b value is 24. So 24 divided by 2 squared is going to be 12 squared, since 24 divided by 2 is 12, and then 12 squared is 144. And number 25, my b value is the fraction 9/13. So when I divide that by 2, or in other words, multiply by 1/2, and then square that quantity, I'll get 9 over 26 squared, and then I'll distribute that exponent of 2 to the 9 and 26. So I'll have 9 squared over 26 squared, which is equal to 81 divided by 676. Since 9 squared is 81 and 26 squared is 676. So our b value in number 26 is 12. So we're going to take 12, divide that by 2, and then square that quantity in order to complete the square. 12 divided by 2 is 6, so we'll have 6 squared, which equals 36. For number 27, our b value is a whole number 28. So 28 divided by 2 squared, 28 divided by 2 is 14, and when we square that quantity, we'll get 196 as our c value. And number 28, again, our b value is 10. So 10 over 2 squared is equivalent to 5 squared, which is 25. For number 29, our b value is 40. So we're going to take that b value, divide it by 2, and then square it. 40 divided by 2 is 20, and 20 squared is equal to 400. So 400 is our solution for completing the square in number 29. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 30. Number 30, our b value is 28. So we'll take that b value, divide it by 2, and then square that quantity. 28 divided by 2 is 14, and 14 squared is equal to 196. So 196 is our final solution on this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.